Hi all, pleased to meet you. I'm Marco Zannini, worldwide business developer of 101 Cafe, and I welcome you to our first webinar in English language. At first, I would like to thank to give a thank you to my company because people registered for this webinar comes from 29 different countries. So there is a world here. We will discuss about our franchise. We will discuss about what is in general franchise, what are our solutions, and also how we manage the situation with COVID-19. We can proudly tell that we are the only one franchise on artisanal Italian coffee. That we invented a concept store of high quality coffee in all its forms. It means that we selected coffee from different roasting companies in Italy and starting from their traditional recipes and local regional tastes, we moved to any different kind of support in the market. So we moved from beans to ground coffee to any kind of capsules and pods you can find in the market. Here we show you a little bit of a map of Italy with the regions where we selected our coffee. We have the target to complete Italy having blends for any different region. Here I introduce a little bit about franchising. If more than you already know what is franchise, there is a franchisor. In this case, we talk about 101 Cafe. Franchisor is a company that invented a business model with a particular and specified know-how, tested this model, and after getting successful results. Shared this business model to other entrepreneurs. Other entrepreneurs could be franchisees, but also master franchisees. Master franchisee is usually a company, but well, is a particular kind of franchisee because we are talking about an entrepreneur that would like to develop a territory. Moving with more units and also moving with sub-franchising. So we can find three main categories of franchisee. A first one is self-employment. So it's a guy that would like to work in something owned by himself. So I open my activity, I work inside, this is my job, and this is my activity. Multi-unit franchisee is a guy that would like to open more, to run more units. He could open more units with the same brand, he could open more units with different brand. But in any case, the identity of franchisee here in this case is multi-unit. Master franchisee is the one that would like to, again, to develop a full territory. A full territory could be a portion of a country, could be a full country or could also include more countries. Here you can see where we are at present. We miss our latest partner in Bulgaria. Right now we already opened in Switzerland, Morocco, Armenia, Kuwait, and Singapore. We totally have 7 units in the world, plus of course 120 here in Italy. And by the end of year, we have the project to run Qatar, to run Saudi Arabia, Maldives, Austria, hopefully also France, due to, well, we will discuss about effects of COVID. So maybe the opening in France will be delayed to the end of 2020, beginning of 2021. And French Guiana, and finally also Réunion and Czech Republic that are looking for the location. Coffee market is very important, and coffee market is particular because in period of crisis, coffee doesn't lose its commercial power. Now we are talking about the second business in the world after petrol, and effects of COVID and of in general of crisis usually don't affect the coffee market. So here we discuss about 5 points in this webinar. What it means franchising, why would I run a store or coffee shop with one-on-one cafe, how we are managing COVID-19 effects, what are concrete advantages in opening an activity through a franchising business compared to a traditional retail, and finally, what are a profile of franchisor for you and franchisee for us. I go quite quickly on the definition of franchising. What is the difference between franchising and another kind of partnership? Is the know-how, basically, because you could have an agreement for affiliation, concession, license, where you have a brand, where you have products, but here you don't have know-how. Know-how is a property of franchising. So, know-how is a transfer from the experience to the franchisor to that transfer is know-how to the franchisee. So, completely in a model of franchising, you have a brand, a range, particularly a know-how and assistance. Here we go in details about 1-on-1 Cafe. As I told you, we are in a very, very strange time, and our unit didn't suffer for the crisis. On the other hand, on the opposite, some units got their best results in their history because people are moving, and customers are moving. Slightly to different business models. So some customer is moving from traditional retail to online. Some others are moving their consumption of coffee from coffee shop to their private consumption due to smart working, due to lockdown, due to problems also in trust. About places where you sit down and you have and you take something to drink and to eat on site. So I'm talking about coffee shop and restaurants. The experience of franchisor could reduce strongly the risk to face big mistakes and the cost for running an activity. Why I separated these ones? Because you can also run an activity by yourself. You can also run an activity in coffee segment. You select your suppliers, you select your brands, you select your products, you prepare the business, and later, maybe, of course, you could be successful and you could be not. But in any case, here you have only your own experience that could be also strong. And your own understanding. So if you don't understand how it's happening, what is happening, that's very, very difficult for you to solve issues. And this could be important in running the activity, before running the activity, and later. For example, every time we run a new unit, we define the range of products to start with a unit, and this is absolutely normal, this is absolutely standard, but it makes sense because we have experience in many countries, and we can suggest you what are our top sellers and our strongest products for people. Well, here we show our strength points. You will also find our video. We in 2019, 2020, we won the award Insegna dell'anno. Insegna dell'anno means that we won the award as best retail store in coffee category. We won the other one finalist was Nespresso, so we are absolutely proud about it. And we won for in our opinion for these strength points. Made in Italy products, a very wide range, a warm welcoming, our activities in multi-channel sales. And we have several business formula that we can adapt to local info. Here are the other awards we got. Not only Retailer of the Year, but also we won the award for Prodotto del Cuore, is literally Product of My Heart. We received again vote from final customers, and we won in 2019-2020 for Napoletano. And the year before for Nocciolino. Well, here you can see what is our mood. Okay, what is our mood? What is our packaging and how we communicate that we are an Italian brand with products made in Italy and premium. This is, of course, only an example because our range consists of more than 1,000.6 selections, including coffee, gourmet coffee, hot drinks, coffee makers, accessories, and everything necessary to provide a full coffee experience. We experienced since now that everywhere we opened outside Italy, we are working with one-on-one cafe products, and the average margin is up to 50%. This is our experience at present, and this is very important because in food retail, this margin is very, very high compared to the traditional food retail. Food retail is repetition, so you usually, maybe you already know that you usually work with lower margin. Lower, for example, than cloth business, accessories business, bijou, and so on. Well, here you have a short resume about our range. Italian regional coffee, pure origin coffee, gourmet coffee and drinks, wellness drinks, tea infusion, chamomiles. We also have some soups. So we experienced many segments, many niche that you can find and you can have locally. Trends are very important in coffee markets. Trends are very important everywhere. As you can see by our certifications, we also have organic products. We have rainforest certified products, vegan okay, lactose free, gluten free, and so on. And our range includes any different capsule, pod, and so on. Actually, we work with 12 different capsules and two different pods. Here you have an overview about the coffee makers. Coffee makers are essential in our business, so we decided to move production by our own, so we can control fully the production process for any equipment is branded 101 Cafe. So we can also give you a better support in any case. Also in after sales, of course. And close to coffee makers and accessories, you also find the other ones, products branded 101 Cafe. We created another brand called Le Sfiziosità for anything is sweet and connected with coffee, so biscuits, sugars, toppings, cakes, and again, so on. While here you find what is included in the range for coffee shop model and co for coffee truck model. Because in this kind of business formula, you can cover the full day. So you can start with breakfast, later with coffee break, later again with soft lunch, a full lunch with pasta, pizza, meat, fish, and so on. And finally, you can continue in the afternoon with homemade ice cream. When we discuss about our world welcoming, we discuss about all of senses. So you can involve your customer with everything. You can involve him with taste. Let him taste our products in the degustation area. For eyes with warm colors, welcoming people to come inside. Coffee aromas, of course, is for the nose. Italian music is for the ears. And finally, lights and packaging are elements, essential elements to connect everything together. Well, a short overview about our e-commerce. Why short? Because here I explain you what is the sense of e-commerce for us in Italy. This is a support for our units, and of course, this is also support for our brand awareness covering the full country. But e-commerce is set up to let the full margin for any sale to our stores. So in the event we have one store in Milano and we complete a sale in the exclusivity area of the store, the full margin is for the store, is not for the mother company. So website is a sort of display to invite people to enter in one cafe mode by their home, but later they can also move to the store to see face to face what is our range and to taste what we have. E-commerce and app are basically when we discuss about multi-channel activity. Because you know that today your customer is not the one that comes inside the store. Of course, this is your customer, but your customer is also the one that, well, know the brand, maybe also know your store, but doesn't come to you because he prefers to place an order by his mobile. He would like to place an order by the e-commerce because he has more time to explore all products with no contact with the seller. This is important in the mind of people now in COVID time, but this is also important country by country, thinking to what is the habit of people. For example, if I think to Poland, well, I dealt with many people coming from Poland, and all of them told me that Polish guys are not attracted by contact, and they prefer to choose and select what they like by themselves. So, of course, in this case, maybe they will work more with e-commerce and with app. Well, now we come to our business models. Our business model are basically four. We have store. We have store is our history. So is food retail. You enter in a place where you find, a coffee word. You can choose what you prefer. You buy and you have your private consumption. It could be at home. It could be in your office. It could be in your company. It could be also in your bar or in your restaurant, so you can also work with professionals. But anyway, the guy comes to you in your store to buy something is final customer. So here you work with the regulations for retail, so no toilet. So maybe depending by country with a different VAT rate, and with a model where you have usually less people working inside. Later, we improved this kind of model, adding a coffee shop. So we created a coffee shop plus market inside. We improved our experience. We selected other Italian products, and we created a place where you can sit down. eat, drink, and have a moment in your day at any time in the morning, in lunch break, in coffee break, in the afternoon, when you prefer. Later again, we sought something in the middle, so we created store plus takeaway. It was before COVID, but this is particularly interesting now in COVID time, because here regulation is close to the one of store, and here you don't work with refrigerated equipments and with refrigerated food. You usually work with something easy to be managed, with no kitchen, with a model closer to the store. And again, country by country, location by location, here you could have the same regulation of the store. For example, there are most countries where here you don't need to have the toilet, exactly as in store. Finally, my boss, invented our coffee truck. It was a fantastic idea to create something, this is a sort of coffee shop on the road. So you can drink your cup of coffee, you can eat the same food you eat in coffee shop. But here you don't have a physical location, but you have a truck. We created this one at first to promote our brand, but it was beautiful. So we decided to move also as a concept store. And we improved again this idea with Apecar. Apecar is interesting because this is also cheaper than coffee truck, and it could be a very, very interesting way to have a short investment and to have a quite easy business. Here you can see some pictures coming from different business model and from different countries. You can see coffee truck, you can see coffee shop, you can see our retail stores. And well, some details about store and what is the full layout here. Our takeaway model and a couple of different layout. As you can see here, you have more. The general view is on store. You feel this concept, this layout more as retail, while you feel this one more as coffee shop. Of course, we can adapt the concept because basically we use the same equipment, the same kind of shop fitting, but we can amend by location and by country. Here you can find a full coffee shop, so having more space dedicated to sittings and also to the counter. And finally, the coffee truck. We decided to create a new payoff, Gourmet Italiano, to describe all of food you have in coffee shop and in coffee truck, because this is really gourmet, and this is something you can spend with people, because we selected something very, very good, easy to be prepared, with no professional chef, and with no professional pastry, so you can work by simple employees, but providing something very Italian and very now. What about COVID-19? You probably heard that Italy was hit strongly by COVID. We were the first country in Europe having the contagion, the big contagion, and the pandemic. So we are also the first one coming out by this situation. Anyway, we never closed our company, never, because we are food, We are food producers, and most of our units are food retail. So when you have food retail, even if in lockdown, you can provide food to final customers. So our units were allowed to be open, but they needed to change a lot their the way to work, because people were afraid to go outside the home, to go to buy food physically. And we needed to improve something by the mother company and something locally. What we did, on local base, we improved the delivery and takeaway. So it means that our stores started in moving their opening hours, their working hours, and they went to final customer. The final effect was that the final customer was engaged better, because I go to your home, I meet your family, I meet you. We can discuss a little bit more with no other people in the same place. And you can create a relationship. This is very important, because as I told you in my premises, we work with repetition. And here we created new engagement. We got new customers that maybe before went to coffee shop or bought coffee in supermarket. Later, we improved as a mother company our e-commerce to create something more user-friendly. And we improved the assistance. For example, we introduced a number for WhatsApp to provide assistance in real time. Furthermore, and this is very, very, very important, we updated our stores at any time about regulations. So it means that we were aligned with government about regulations, and we sent in real time to all of stores in different regions where we have different regulations, we updated all of them about what they need to do in order to work regularly, correctly, following the correct application of procedures to secure themselves, their business, and of course, final customer. Here we are proud to communicate, to tell you that all of our stores gave coffee for sanitary structure on local base, and we never told to one of our store to do it, to work in this way. They decided by their own. We did the same. We provided coffee to our to people working, to doctors and nursery and any kind of people working in sanitary, because we are in Lombardia, we are close to Milano, and our region was the one with the biggest emergency, not only in Italy but maybe in all of Europe, and one of the most hit in the world. I discussed a little bit about us. Now I do a short comparison with a traditional business and a franchising business. What is the difference? Basically, you can today you can decide that your business will be coffee. You decide to look for a location by your own, of course, but okay, you decide your products, you decide the colors, you decide the company name, you decide what is the brand, you decide, you select people to sell your products inside the unit. But our market seems to be easy, but in fact, in details, is very, very complicated. So what I can tell you is that we have experience in supporting our franchisee in selecting the location and defining the location. We can provide our experience in training and support, not only in pre-opening, but of course in opening, and of course later, because the most important chapter for a franchise, a relationship in franchise, is after the opening, is not before. We can provide assistance for any activity. It could be for orders, for stock management, for logistics, for advertising. It could be also for the software. We grant an exclusive area. This is sometimes underestimated. Anyway, okay, you at present in your country, you cannot find a 101 cafe in supermarket. I can tell you it's not important what is your country, but we are not working with supermarket in any country in the world. So you cannot find our products there. You have no competition with them. You have no competition with other wholesalers selling 101 cafe because you have your exclusivity area. Maybe it could be the full country, and you can decide your action to sell in your exclusive area with no competitors having our products and our brand. Finally, we can provide the full assistance to install your unit, even if maybe you do the installation by your own, because this is also our experience. Our partners in Morocco, in Singapore, in Kuwait, in Armenia, realize the shop fitting by their own sometimes due to the customs, sometimes due to the local costs, sometimes due to the regulations, sometimes due to the maintenance. Sometimes because they are master franchisees, so they can create repetition also in with the same equipments and with the same furnitures. But in any case, we can support our partners in the project in any kind of communication and also in continuous update of the unit. Finally, this is the final chapter of the webinar. Later, I will let you the time to place your questions. Well, there are of course two subjects. One is franchisor, and the other one is franchisee. Here you can see listed all of elements you can find in a franchising relationship. So, two entrepreneurs sharing of know-how, sharing of risk, one common target, one exclusivity area, or one training program, of course, to share the know-how, the duration of the agreement, an entry fee stating again exclusive rights in your area, but also all of services we provide for the opening. Here, for example, including translations for labels, royalties for continuous support and transparency in results. So we have no problems in sharing with our partners what we do and also some results we got in the full chain of 101 cafe units all over the world. To let you, well, to give you some ideas more. What I suggest you, today you would like to choose a franchise. Maybe it's 101 Cafe, maybe it's another one. What I suggest you to consider when you select one franchise, I suggest you to consider your attitude. So what would you like to do? What is your interest? It could be a personal interest, your passion, but it could be only a question of money, of course, because this is a commercial activity to get profit. What is the know-how owned by the franchisor? Because if the franchisor has no relevant know-how in your opinion, well, maybe it doesn't make sense you choose his franchising. What is the structure of franchisor? So how is working with logistics, with marketing, with training? Does it have information in your language? I maybe prevent one question, but usually I ask to our prospects, to our potential franchisee, to have a first meeting in our headquarters and visiting our units. For this reason, because I would like you understand who we are and what we before you choose our franchising. Maybe also later, because you already met us, because you already have the idea to run the activity with us. It's important you know what are your obligations. It's important you feel that you can build a relationship, personal and commercial relationship. It's important you understand what it could be the financial situation of the franchisor. If the franchisor is in joined some franchise associations, and also if he is experienced in different countries. Because when I tell you, okay, this is the top seller we have in Italy, but you come from, I don't know, I think two countries for people registered, Bulgaria, Indonesia, Poland, Canada, everywhere in the world, of course, the taste is not the same. But now we are working with, we have units opened in 6 countries. We have partners in other 5 countries. All of them have experience in taste with final customers. So, well, we can tell you this is the top seller, not only in Italy, but also in other countries. And what is the profile we usually look for joining a new franchisee in our team? We need you are empathic. Maybe not you as an entrepreneur, but people in selling. So if you are looking for a unit for self-employment, you need to be empathic. If you are looking for an investment, you need to have leadership and team building, and you need to have attitude in listening to colleagues, customers, and also franchisor. You don't need to follow colleagues, customers, and franchisor, but listening is very important. Usually our top franchisees are the ones that even if they are experienced, they also listen to what we suggest. Later, maybe they decide to move in another way. But before moving to another path, they already thought about what we suggested and nothing more. You need to have an entrepreneurial attitude. This is true for self-employment and for investment. And you need to compare your financial situation with your target. It doesn't make sense that you have €10,000 as a capital to invest, and you would like to open for self-employment, but you would like to open a coffee shop with 200 square meters. It doesn't make sense. So you need to understand what is your situation, what you are looking for, and what is the best match. This is the last one slide where we talk when I talk. Since December 2017, 101 Cafe has become part of Food Empire Holdings. Food Empire is our associate with 25% of ownership in our company. So 101 Cafe is leader in his development and is leader in his strategy. But we can count on a very, very strong and experienced partner working in coffee, working in food and beverage in over 50 nations, particularly in Asian countries. And well, here you can find our contacts to you can contact directly me. More people registered to this webinar have already my email address. But you can also contact my colleague in lead generation to franchising at 101cafe.it. Well, you can ask me exactly what it could be important for you. Now I already received a couple of questions. Well, okay, this here. Okay. I'm sorry. Well, okay, I got it. I finally got it. Well, hi, Mr. Pittis. Yes, we include the UK. We sent our invitation to people in UK, but we joined a lot of guys coming from different countries. How do you ship your products to different country, Mr. Kayal? Well, I can tell it to you quite easily. At present, we usually move with international forwarders. Sometimes our partner already have their forwarders locally, so they provide us directly the contact of the forwarder, and we match with him. Otherwise, we can also contact forwarders for our partners. Anyway, we can ship most of our products as dry, because coffee is a product having from 12 to 36 months of shelf life. So we don't suffer for long transit time. We don't suffer for hot temperature, because coffee is not affected by hot temperature. And also for coffee shop, some of our products are dry. For example, pizza is something we can ship dry together with coffee. Ice cream is something we can ship dry, and also some dry pastry. Otherwise, we move by refrigerated shipment. Yeah, pleased to meet you again, Mr. Ashiabi. Yeah, I remind our meeting during host, and well, as I told you, I suggest you to be in contact, to get in touch with our master franchisee for both countries. Of course, I will come back to you with my pleasure. Anyway, we already have a partner for GCC. Now we opened the first unit in Kuwait, maybe you know, in December 2018. But he's running the business in Qatar and also in Saudi Arabia. Unfortunately, in GCC, you know, Mr. Ashabi, you don't have only a problem of lockdown, but also a problem of curfew. And your lockdown will finish in more than 3 months. So, of course, everything is delayed. Thanks a lot, Mr. Pittis, for your congratulations. Yeah, Syed, we already have a deal with another Italian brand selling coffee capsules and beans. Can we have yours as well? Well, this is a particular question, because in fact, in our stores, in our Italian units, we don't have only 101 Cafe SKU, but we also have Nescafé Dolce Gusto original ones. We also have Lavazza, we have Bialetti, we have Illy, with license by the producer. So I don't know what are the brands you are working with. I don't know also what is the final target for your idea, because we have more than the 600 of SKU branded 101 Cafe. So I don't know, to be honest. It's better to go deeply in details about this matter, because right now I cannot reply you yes or not. What's the cost of store in coffee shop? I'm sorry, Mr. Kayal. I forgot what is the country you are sending me your inquiry. But anyway, I can. Okay. That's good. When we discuss about the double model, coffee shop plus retail inside, the commercial cost, so without knowing what is the location, without having a project, so without having something detailed, the commercial cost is 1,500 euro. This is the basic. And we consider a surface of 80 square meters, but this cost is the Italian cost. So you need to consider that it means that we prepare all of furniture and equipment here. We send everything to you in UK. We send the team to install everything in UK. So they also have the hotel, the travel, the accommodation, and all of costs connected with it. So again, I come back to what I told before. It's not mandatory we provide everything from Italy. This is also a question we can discuss with the franchisee. In France, for example, we found an agreement to do the shop fitting by our own, but the shopping mall where our franchisee is running the activity, the shopping mall forced him to do shop fitting in France. So even if I provide you the costs from Italy, maybe your landlord will force you to do everything in UK. I'm not sure about it. Tuan Abdullah. Oh yeah, absolutely, absolutely. What I suggest is to have a private call. We take our time. We organize a call, in my opinion, by WhatsApp, if this is comfortable for you. And at any time, I have no problem. We can discuss in details deeply. And later, I'm used to discuss. And later to provide the same information by email, so you have no mismatch and we don't have misunderstanding between what we discussed and what you got. But yes, Iraq is a country where we don't have agreements at present, so we can absolutely discuss about single unit, but also master franchising. Minimum is square meters for opening coffee shop plus retail, and approximate royalties being paid. I guess such royalties are per annum too. We said in order to have the double model complete, so you have a little bit of space for coffee shop and a little bit of space for retail, we suggest at least 80 square meters. When I tell you 80 square meters, I'm talking about counter, back counter, and customer area, not including toilet, not including laboratory, and or something similar to the kitchen, because as I told you, we don't need a kitchen. When I told you about the investment, and I told you about 1,500 per square meter, in the investment, well, I give you the full view, 80 square meters plus the laboratory, 1,500 per square meter are 120,000 euro. Just to complete the overview. Royalties are per month. We usually require our franchisee to pay royalty per month. Are open for cooperation in Kosovo? Yes, Mr. Keska. At present, I'm dealing with a couple of guys for Kosovo because I know that your country is very, very strong for coffee, as Albania. Both of them are markets where coffee is very, very, very strong. You drink a lot, there are a lot of coffee shop, and Kosovo is in development. So absolutely we can discuss about it. Well, the same as I told to the Iraqi today to our Iraqi guest, in my opinion, it would be better to discuss about Kosovo in private by WhatsApp again or by email or by both of them. Wait in case there are more questions. Please don't hesitate to place other questions because I'm absolutely open. As I told you before, transparency is one feature in franchising, so I have no secrets. Of course, right now we are talking about something general because this is a general presentation to show you our franchise and how we work. Anyway, send me your email. Absolutely, absolutely. Yes. This is not in discussion, Mr. Keska. I think I will get all of the details also about your questions, but I already have your email address. So I contact all of you in any case next week, and you will also receive the link to download the webinar, to download the slides, to see it again if you have the pleasure to see it again, because this is your choice. And in any case, I stay connected with you. Please do have an idea about cost of location. Sorry. Cost of one location. To be honest, no, because it depends what is the kind of location and if you are asking me about rent or final investment, final CapEx. If you ask me about rent, it depends by the city, the kind of location, the kind of business you would like to run, and also if you have to pay key money or something similar to get the location empty. While if you are asking about CapEx, if you are asking about CapEx is something more complicated because, as I told you, sometimes I directly suggest to my partners to set up to shop fit the unit locally because I well know, for example, that in Eastern Europe costs are lower than Italy. While materials are very good, people are very good in shop fit. So, in my opinion, it doesn't make sense to provide everything from Italy. But in this case, CapEx is something that you need to understand locally, on local basis. When you talk about the investment, if the person already have the place available and all, does he still to pay something else? Apart from the 6% royalties per month and entry fee. Well, okay, maybe I understood the question. In general, in franchising, there are three elements for your investment. This is also to be transparent. One element is the entry fee, and I usually describe it as the unmaterial element. So entry fee represents our know-how, including services, so not including something physical and material, but for example, again, translations, software, new products that we can set up for a new country, the study to define the range, the visit to check locations, the training program, and so on. While investment is the material side. So in the event you need a refrigerator, of course you need to buy a refrigerator. In the event you need furnitures, you need to buy furnitures. If you already have the location and the location is ready for your business because you have a coffee shop and you would like to turn your old coffee shop to 101 Cafe Coffee Shop. Oh, well, now here we are working about renovation. So it means that we don't drive to change everything, but we change what is necessary to create our brand identity, to avoid having misunderstanding and confusion in final customer. But maybe if we discuss about the counter is the most important investment in a coffee shop. In case you already have the counter, we can also limit the renewal of the counter to the panels, having our colors, having our brand identity without changing the structure, of course. So, well, you can save money. And the third level of your costs are royalties, exactly. Oh yeah, Abdullah, this is more or less what I explained right now to Mr. Flavio Vigna. The investment is this one, is the physical side of the unit. So it depends what you place inside the unit. Because when I provide the commercial quotation for shop fitting coming from Italy, this is commercial because later maybe, okay, 1,500 euro per square meter. Okay, later you have less displays or your displays are not refrigerated, but they are dry. Counter is the most important cost in a coffee shop. Counter and any kind of equipment having an engine or having a heater, so having a technology. So, well, you have a smooth counter that you can use for the cash and you can use to provide coffee for coffee to go. No other equipments, no refrigerators, no particular displays because maybe you have one but it's dry, or maybe you have 3 meters of counter instead of 7 meters of counter. You save money. But this is the reason why I tell you that particularly for coffee shop, the investment needs to be the real investment needs to be set up when we set up the project. We can also move from a budget. Okay, you tell me, okay, my budget is I don't know, 100,000 euro instead of 120. But my surface is 90 square meters instead of 80. Okay, we know we have a target. Maybe at the beginning we will have 1 meter less of counter. Maybe at the beginning we will have 1 meter less of shelves that we can improve later if this is necessary, but we stay inside the anyway, trust in me, this is very complicated. And this is the reason why I consider standard quotation for standard surfaces, but I well know that I can't ask you to provide me a location with 80 squared meters. Maybe you find 79, maybe you find 81, maybe you find 60, maybe you find 100. And later, of course, we need to manage something smaller, something bigger, adapting the project. And also adapting the investment. Hi, Mr. Abdullah. Absolutely, yes. I come back to you by email. Yeah, okay. No. 100K is not just a fee. Well, it could be a fee if we discuss about master franchising or something very big. Or a territory not including only one unit, but more. Otherwise, no. 100K could be also a full unit if you consider retail store or retail store plus coffee to go. You probably complete a unit with 100K, having everything included: goods, entry fee. shop fitting, also handcraft to renew the location, and in my opinion also a little bit of funds you keep safe for running the activity. So with 100,000 euro, I don't feel I feel no problems. Okay, that's very good. That's very good. Thanks to Mr. Pittis. I will send him an email to thank him because he left the webinar. So we invested all 101 cafe machinery, coffee machines, counters will be included. Yes. Yes, if you consider the full investment per square meters, of course you also have counters, coffee makers, and everything. Absolutely, absolutely. Okay. It's 18, so we are exactly on time. If you have any other question, no problem to extend the webinar. Okay, thanks, Mr. Ashabi. The best to you. The best to you. Thanks for your congratulations, Mr. Abdullah. How much stock per month one is to order? Well, this is a very clever question, Mr. Vigna, but this okay, I try to provide you a reply because this is not so easy. Because again, it depends by the kind of business you are running. Because if you have coffee shop, you need to move orders more quickly because well, if you work hardly with people coming every day, you need to renew the stock quite quickly. So you have two choices every time for this kind of business. You have a higher stock, so you have a higher financial exposition, but you have less transport, or you have more shipments and less stock. So this is a strategy. It depends by the cost of logistics compared to the cost of transport. And this is also a question of what you use. Because again, when you move, if you move refrigerated products, you usually have less shipments because refrigerated shipments are more expensive. So you will probably charge yourself with more quantities, with less shipments. Marketing, do you get your own website and advertising leaflets? We have a full department for marketing. So we created our own catalogs at present in four languages, Italian, sorry, in three languages basis for any kind of materials we have. Italian, French, and English. We are using all of them for any kind of platform, for any kind of document we prepare. We also have materials for social media already translated and prepared in French and in English. But we also prepare new contents for our partners based on what they need. So we can do our advertising by social media for you. We can prepare graphics for you. And advertising leaflets, exactly. And well, we usually leave the printing activity to local to avoid to charge you for shipping costs because it doesn't make sense. You pay the shipment for something you can print locally. This is in my experience and in my opinion. When you mentioned laboratory, what did you mean exactly? Yes. Is it a machinery or space area for catering? Well, I explain you what I mean. Okay, you enter in a restaurant, you enter in a coffee shop, you enter in a place where you have service, quick service or slow service. But you sit down, you order something, and you get something prepared. Prepared more or less means that it could be hot or cold, but you know that this is prepared. This is not dry. This is not a bag that you open with something with a snack, for example. Okay. So everything is prepared, could be cooked or finished. You cook something when you have a chef, basically, or you cook pastry when you have a guy skilled in pastry, and so on. So in this case, you have a real kitchen, because you prepare everything. When I discuss about laboratory, I discuss about a room where you have your stock, the most of your stock for food. You take food and you finish to prepare your food. Later, you bring the food you prepared to the location, so you can show in the display and you can serve to people fresh, prepared some minutes before. This is what I mean as laboratory. So this is the room where you have all of the equipments, and all of these equipments are included in the total investment because they are functional to the activity. When we discuss about food, when we discuss about retail, I think you probably know, maybe not, but this is not so important. I explain it to you. Well, the final customer is attracted by the store. So what is important to be shop fit is the store. While your stock is usually on metallic shelves, and metallic shelves are very cheap, are very easy, are not complicated, so we don't include them in the investment, because you have a small space where you place some metallic shelves. There is no a big a huge difference. While in coffee shop you could have a huge difference, because refrigerated shelves are expensive, ovens are expensive, of course more than metallic shelves. Okay, are the prices reasonable also for customers? Of course. Of course. You can think to franchising. If our prices are not competitive because we decided to get a lot of money with a huge margin, so we sell with a huge margin to our units, you can imagine our units have no margin. They cannot work, they stop the activity, and franchising is development. So if you don't provide conditions to others to work, it doesn't make sense to do franchising, because franchising is a relationship between two entrepreneurs. So we need to get profit and you need to get profit. So you need to provide something to the final customer with a reasonable price, and in order to do it, of course, you have pressure in competition, because in any country in the world there is a pressure in competition, maybe stronger, maybe easier, okay? But of course, if we don't provide reasonable prices to you, you cannot run your activity. But you know it before running the activity. Because before running the activity, it's mandatory you set up at least a business plan for the specific location you defined or we defined together. Because otherwise, you have no idea. You will ask me, but do you think I get back money? Do you think I get back profit? Well, it depends. As I told you, maybe you have 10,000 euro to invest and you would like to open a big coffee shop. So you ask a lot of money to the bank to set up the coffee shop, but you didn't think that you will need to have employees inside. So you don't have to consider only funds to run the activity, but also funds to hire people, to pay the rent, because maybe the first day you will have your unit profitable, the first day. But maybe you will need 1 month, maybe you will need 3 months. This is connected to the location. This is connected to the model. This is something you need to understand. You need to have a realistic situation before running your activity. Not important if this is with one of a cafe, with another one brand, by your own, but you need to have a realistic vision before running an activity. I think this is finished. I thank all of you. I thank again my company because I had the opportunity to discuss with many, many countries in the world. It was the first time for me. I discussed with 29 different countries. I never did it also in franchising exhibitions. Proud for my company. Thanks to all of you. Thanks for your question, for your time. Get in touch for next future.